I'm Callum Harrington.
This is our vlog for the last 5 years, a production we're putting on through GJ Productions, mine and Jack Wilkinson's new theatre company.
During this rehearsal process, we're going to actually track everything and record how it's gone and how we're creating the show and putting everything together. So this is what this vlog form is, just to give you guys a bit of an update and also for us to really reflect on how we're putting together the show.
Yeah, it's helping us work through our ideas. It's going to help us figure out how we felt about the show before and how we feel after when we go into debriefing how the whole process happened. So in each video, we'll go through what we did to warm up, to any exercises we did, and then what scenes we worked on. So today we're rehearsing at the Bev Palmer Performing Arts Studios. Thank you very much for having us. And we start with some exercises.
Yeah, so we first warmed up just by popping on some tunes and just doing some plate work exercise where one of us will be dominant and one of us will be minor, and just mirroring each other playing in the space more than anything, just trying to establish that connection that we feel is very vital to the show, that these are two people who are very connected but can be distanced from each other a little play.
So we were really looking for complicity. That was the goal out of this exercise. And I kind of felt for the first maybe 2 or 3 minutes of the exercise, I was just so lost. I completely forgotten what it meant to really be complicit with someone. So I mean, my eyes were all over the shop. I really wasn't looking at you properly. Yeah. I think I was looking somewhere around you, like your shoulder line. For some reason, and then my eyes would dart around and I was like, wait, what is this about?
Yeah.
What do we need to get out of this? And the most important thing for me was getting back in touch with another actor. I've been working on more of the production side of a lot of things in the last year or two. So this is the first kind of project I'm really going as the actor again, pretty much since uni. So for me, it was a lot about getting back in touch.
Getting back into it, yeah. I know for me that it took a little bit longer as well. This has been one of the, like, getting back into doing stage performance for me. This is going to be fun. But yeah, getting in space, just being there with Grace and just really kind of connect. And also just having fun. The next exercise that we actually did after that, we started playing with body contact and just moving in the space, and we both felt that was very very controlled, very much like what we had expected from uni, as though we were making a theatre piece on its own and everything had to be calculated.
Yes, oh, that is actually the perfect word for it.
Yeah.
It was so controlled and so calculated.
Yep, it looked nice.
Oh, it was great, but not right
for what we really wanted. And then the song changed. Every time the song would change, we like change with the song and have that be the outside stimulus for our connection.
Yeah.
And the song changed and it just was fun. It was
so good. It just completely changed the exercise. We went from really almost overthinking every movement to all of a sudden breaking out into It was just total freedom.
Just having fun.
Yeah.
And it was great as well because we had established fairly early on that, we have to keep contact. And that was the point of the exercise, is keeping contact and just making sure that we were always touching one another in some way. And then there was a moment where we had just unintentionally had broke away from each other. And it took you a moment to realize.
I didn't even notice for a whole like 10 seconds or something. That feels like a really long time.
Yeah.
When you're in the exercise.
But what was great is that instead of analyzing it, we just kept going. Just like, okay, cool. So now the rules have changed and we can touch and can't touch and how we can play with that. Still playing with that major minor idea as well.
Yeah, so the first exercise of the plate and balancing and finding the major and minor in each other and finding the complicity moved into the next exercise with touch and not touch. It was so unintentional, but so like beneficial for us starting this whole process to realize, oh, we are still back in touch with everything that we need.
Yeah.
Like all our tools, all the things that we need to create this show are right at our disposal, right there, ready to go. Because for me, I thought I wasn't sure how easy it would be to get back into this process.
Mm-hmm. So then we went into a bit of scene work, just establishing where we want to start the show. It's definitely hard to start any show, but the beauty of it is that it usually says it in the script. We've got a vague idea on how we kind of want it to start off, but when in doubt, we're just going to go back to the script and really kind of crack down on that. But allowing ourselves to play with it as well. I mean, we just spent an hour kind of working on the opening sequence, kind of where is it starting, where is it ending? And from there, hopefully it will merge into other things. Then we went into the second sequence, which was mine. The whole point of the show is that it's very much that there's one sequence that's Grace's sequence and then one sequence that will be mine. So it's taking turns in that, so we've kind of dedicated that about an hour each on each one, just to really kind of get a play with it, just to begin with. I mean, further down the line, hopefully we'll be able to work on it a little bit more.
So we might not have mentioned, we will be co-directing the show, and we felt that this was probably the best way to go about this show because it is only two people, and each sequence is driven by one of the characters. So it gives us a bit of freedom to step outside the show and to observe together. But you know, when we can't figure it out for ourselves or we need someone's outside of the point of view, that third eye, we'll bring in Jack to observe. He'll also be taking our show, so he's going to have a really good grasp on the flow of the show, how it feels.
We also worked on Grace's opening sequence, which is her character Kathy dealing with some pretty heavy issues, and kind of going from there. The struggle that we kind of started off with was Grace did it in such a way that it was nearly a final product. You sat down and it was nice, it was great to see.
It sounded
good. It was good work. It sounded nice. It looked nice. It was very controlled and contained, just something that we both want to get away from.
Yeah, it's a challenge for me as an actor, because that's kind of my go-to thing, is to really think about what I want to do before I've even done it.
Then, because we're trying to get away from this kind of end product idea. Well, what we've been doing today is that we just kind of run through the sequence and then try to disrupt each other or try to bring something to it. So after Grace had done the first run of the sequence, I came in and I added certain stimulus, or I gave her limitations, and so that she had a different realm to play with. And I know towards the end, we just had so many more different variations, so many different colours to work with.
Yeah.
Instead of just being one kind of upset colour, we then had different, someone being sad, someone being angry, someone who's desperate, and being able to go from there. And
that being the foundation level, which we can then build upon throughout the rehearsal process. So beneficial for me. The stimulus from Callum was fantastic. It just opened up a whole bunch of different options, a whole bunch of different choices to make. And that's where we found ourselves, maybe I think it was two or three times after that we found some, as you say, some different colours to work with, which is great. Which then, you know, we moved on to your number, the next sequence in the show. And for the first run of it, as the director for you, I just let you go and see what happened the first run through. And then the second run, I almost overstimulated you. I gave you so much to...
Simulation is a word, yes. My challenge is that I'm singing to you while you're not there.
Yeah.
Essentially. So we then had to, it was a great run to have her, like have Grace there and that be the seamless and I'm singing to her.
Mm.
But then it's being able to take that away, take you away and still have that there.
Yeah.
Which is going to be the challenge for me. So next week, I think that we just want to go back to, again, same warm up kind of process, maybe go back, look at some books from uni, to some books.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, go back to what we learned from uni, kind of work on some more connection kind of exercises. And from there, again, just work on these sequences. I think it would be good just to keep doing that each week. We do one sequence for you, one sequence for me.
Yeah.
And from there we can, we'll get through the show and then we'll come back and do them again. Oh, because we have a very long rehearsal period at this stage, considering this is going to be on when, Grace?
The show will be on in the last week of August, leading into the first days of September.
Great. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Can't wait to see it.
I know. So we do have a very long rehearsal period, mm-hmm. Process, but we will be rehearsing most likely 1 to 2 times a week, and that's to do with getting space and work, because, you know, got to have a day job.
Yeah.
and
moving house.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. Other such things.
And living some life somewhere. In the month.
You get those? Yeah. You get those lives? I don't get to live those lives.
No, I don't really have that. No.
Anyway.
Okay, thank you so much for watching. I hope you get a little bit out of this as to, you know, what we're doing with this show. Get a bit of an insight into who we are and what we're about.
So if you have any questions, just write them down below and we'll hopefully address them. And we'll see you in the next coming weeks. Stay tuned. Bye.
Bye.